Dave's Kitchen, and today we're going to do some arancini balls. I know it sounds fancy, but it's really not. It's made with the leftover risotto that I made on Friday night, and you can't leave it in the fridge that long anyways. Well, not too long, but I can't eat all that. So I have to figure out different recipes to compensate for that. So we're going to do that. We're going to do a quick marinara sauce. And it's not going to take like 25 spices. It's going to just take like a few spices. And we're good. Let's get on with it. Okay, folks. First thing we're going to do is... we're gonna cut these tomatoes, and you don't want all this middle section in. It's just like a lot of like juice, and it's just gonna make it too soggy. We're gonna continue on with that. So, cut the tomatoes like, you know what, guys? You don't have to be perfect. Okay? Cut them up. Put them in a bowl. And this is the easiest way, I find, anyways. You know, I mean, there's probably easier ways, but... this is the easiest way I have found. And once you cut them up, put them all in the bowl. We're going to make a quick marinara sauce. I mean quick. And it's actually going to come from, well, not a jar, but like a bottle. And... you know, like, all these people with like 2,500 spices, doesn't work. Okay, so what we're going to do is add in like, I don't know, teaspoon and a half basil. We're going to add in 2 teaspoons of garlic. We're going to add in 1 teaspoon of lemon juice. We're going to add in like, okay, this is my kicker, but it's 1 teaspoon of horseradish. And then we're going to add in 1 teaspoon salt and pepper. And we're going to mix it all together. Put it in the fridge. Because really, you know, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of pepper, because really, it's got to be cold. Okay? So I've already got the oven preheated, and last thing we want to add is... I don't know, 3 to 4 tablespoons of olive oil. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so we're going to do a marinara sauce after this, because what we're going to do... is, you know what, sometimes, guys, like, you know, on a Friday, you don't want to order out. You know what, I don't blame you. You don't want to order out. You just want to make something, sit in the comfort of your own home. And being the way that it is right now, just, this isn't going to take that long to make. Okay, so we're going to set this aside, put it in the fridge, and make it cool, because you need cold dressing on the hot crostinis. A quick, kind of like a marinara sauce here. And I've already got the oil up to temp, and we're gonna add some onions. And we're gonna cook them until they're like translucent, which is like soft. You know? We're gonna add like a few spices. We're gonna add like some garlic, red pepper flakes. We're gonna add some oregano and some basil. Not 25 spices, not 10 spices, not 8 or whatever. We're gonna add in like a few spices just to enhance the flavor. And, you know, like, I watch these videos and it's just like, it boggles my mind how many people watch these videos and, I don't know. They must follow them. They must follow the recipes. I don't know. It boggles my mind. You know, like, because, like, we're cooking, you know, and that's what you want to do, is cook. And, you know what, on a, like I said, on a weeknight, Friday night or Saturday night or something, you worked all day or... Well, maybe you didn't on a Saturday, but anyways, you work, you want to make something, you want to watch a movie, you want to kind of like munch, little bit of this, little bit of that. So that's what we're going to do. And we're going to do like some of these rice balls, some bruschetta. And that should get you full. Okay, so let this cook a minute and we'll be back. Okay, onions are done. Next thing, garlic. Okay, so garlic, 30 to 45 seconds. And this is like, I don't know, about 2 teaspoons of garlic. And, can smell it already. So all you got to do is just cook it 30 to 45 seconds, and then we're going to add in chili peppers, oregano, basil. Mix it around, because when you put dry spices in, it's going to bring out the flavors and enhance the sauce. Now, next thing, I'm gonna add some red wine, and I'm using a jar. Okay, so this sauce, it's like some San Marzano tomatoes, but it's in a jar. Okay, so red wine goes in next. And just kind of like cook it down, reduce it. And all you need to do is have the heat over medium, medium low. Reduce it, and all it's going to do is enrich the sauce. Okay, so we're not using like 500 spices here. We're using a few. And there you go. Okay, it's cooked down. and about 3/4 of this bottle, which is basically like, well, it's not tomato paste, but it's a combination. Okay, so it's like tomato paste and tomatoes all in one thing. It's strained tomatoes. Okay, so that's all you got to do is add that. It's like 3/4 of the bottle, because these things that we're making, I mean, I really don't know how many we're going to get, but you know what? Let's just cook this and see how many we end up getting, and we're going to go from there. Okay, folks, nice and red, bright red. That's the way it should be. Now, next thing we're going to do is this is going to simmer for about another 20 minutes. And I've already got the crostini prepared. And we're going to do the rice balls next. Okay, folks. Well, I was going to use this scoop here, but it's not big enough. So, I mean, you gotta have this stuff like, you know, like a good ball. Because what we're gonna do is I got a bunch of mozzarella. Okay, so put a hole in the middle and shape it back around. I've already spiced, I've got salt and pepper in each thing, and the flour and the egg mixture, and well, the panko is already seasoned. So, you know what? Mix it around here, put it in the egg mixture, and then put it in the panko. Okay, and well, I know they're kind of big balls, but you know, like it's arancini. They're supposed to be big balls, like not golf ball size, but you know, like half decent size. And, you know, just poke a hole in the middle, put the mozzarella in, and roll it back around into a bowl. And dip it in all the mixtures. You know, like I said, I don't know how many I'm going to get here. But, you know, just keep doing it. I should get, I don't know. I figure I should get about 6 good-sized balls anyways. And, you know, just keep shaping them and putting the putting the mozzarella cheese in the middle. Like I said, poke a hole, put the mozzarella cheese in the middle, and you know, do all the breading. And then what we're gonna do is instead of deep fry it, which normally is the case, we're going to put it in the oven. And why not? You know, I'm not putting it in an instant fryer. I'm not putting it in, well, mind you, you probably could, you know, yeah, you probably could, you know, but I'm not doing that. I'm just, doing it the old-fashioned way here. And that's why it's called, it's Aaron Cheney balls. And, why mess around with, the way that it's always been done? So if I get six of them here, which, I probably should, now you can use this for like, because we're going to do some bruschetta. So you can use this for like, like I said, a side. You can use it for the main thing. You can use it for, if you got the munchies, this is what you do. You got leftover rice, roll it around, mix it all together, and there you go. Snacks ready. Okay, so there's five. Yeah, so I'll get six. Based on what I made. If you're making it, there's no point in throwing it out. You might as well just make something else out of it instead of throw it out. And if you can make something else out of it that's half decent and doesn't require 500 spices, why not? There we go. Okay, so I got six out of it. Six pretty big balls. let me wash my hands here. So, six pretty big balls. And we got this quick little, you can make a full-fledged marinara sauce, but if you're hanging out and you're doing like a movie night on Friday or something like that, this is the way to do it. Take a jar of that stuff, empty it in with some onions, garlic, chili flakes, a little bit of basil, oregano, and simmer it. Same thing with those. Heat the oven up to 425 because guys? So we're going to put that in for about 15 minutes, maybe 20 minutes. But by the time you order stuff on the weekend, especially, it's gonna take a while. So by that time, you can have this stuff done, and it's made at home. You don't have to go anywhere, and you can hang out, have a drink, do whatever you want to do. And that's how quick it is. Okay, so we're going to be back in a minute. We're going to finish it up and we're done. Okay, folks. Let's check it out. Oh. Cheese. Inside. Well, you didn't have to add 25 spices to that. All you need to add was a few spices. Garlic, onion, basil, oregano, salt, pepper, that kind of stuff. And you know what? Let's check out these. Same thing. And you know what? You didn't have to add like 25 spices. You didn't have to do any of the stuff in a crock pot or a instant pot or whatever it's called. Like I said, I got nothing against them, but you know what? You want to cook, then cook. Don't throw tons of spices in and just mask it, like sour cream and mayonnaise and tons of spices on top of fish. Like, that's ridiculous. So, anyways, hit the notification bell, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and we'll see you next time. Take care, stay safe, see you later.